post-its. Reminders from God, the strength for our journey. Today we're going to look upon a very wonderful animal that is known as the world's tallest mammal. I hope you guessed it right. It's none other than the giraffe. Yes, the giraffe stands around 18 feet tall. You can imagine how tall it would be. A human being could be 6 feet tall or 6.5 feet, but a giraffe here stands 18 feet tall. Quite tall, isn't it? That's the reason it's called the world's tallest mammal. Yes, and how long would it live? It lives over 35 years. And you would have seen that the giraffe has some specific spots on its body. It is very specific, just like you see the stripes on a zebra or the fingerprints of a human being. Even the spots on the giraffe is very specific. Yes, these are herbivorous animals. They eat lots and lots of pounds of leaves, and to find these leaves, they need to travel miles together to get the food that they actually need. They eat so much, so just imagine how many stomachs would these giraffes have. Well, a human body has one stomach, isn't it? But this giraffe has four stomachs. My goodness, it has four stomachs. And having four stomachs, just imagine how long its intestines would be. It is 230 feet long. That's incredible, unbelievable, right? 230 feet long, the intestine. Coming to the tongue is 18 inch long. So long, 18 inch long. That's the reason it helps to get the leaves from the taller trees. It will swirl its tongue and get those leaves. And coming to the weight of the tongue of a female giraffe, it's around 1,500 pounds, whereas a male has a tongue that weighs 2,500 pounds. Coming to its lungs, the capacity of it to hold the air is around, the lungs can hold around 12 gallons, that is 45 to 46 liters of air in its lungs. So if you want to compare it with a human lungs, a human lung has the capacity of holding around 1.59 gallons or like 4 to 5 liters of air in our lungs. Just imagine, ours is just 4 to 5 liters and the giraffe could hold 45 to 46 liters. So how large and big its lungs are. They can swim, but not very well, and they can also jump. But with those long legs, why does it need to jump also, right? So we see that when we speak of those long legs, the front legs are 10% longer than the back legs, and they can run short distances, like around, like quick distances of 35 mph and sustained distances at 10 mph. But both walking and running, they have to use the pacing gait. That means they have a specific way of walking, like with the legs on each side moving in unison together. So the right side legs would go together in front and the left side at the back. So both together, they work in unison together, right? And this giraffe, it travels not alone, but always in groups. And groups of 10 to 20 giraffes. And you know what are they called? The groups of giraffes are called as towers. They are called as towers. And they do not sleep also for extended period. They do not sleep. They rest, or they rather only rest about 20 minutes, maximum 20 minutes. But in between, they take power naps of 2 to 3 minutes. Like power naps, just quick naps, like sleeping for a few minutes and then again wake up and go on. In a day, I'm talking about in a day. And giraffes have excellent eyesight because of their height. They can see something that's moving from a very far away place, they could see something that's mile away. It could see with its eyesight. It has a very excellent eyesight. It has no vocal cords, but it communicates with some other sounds, and they also at the night times they hum, but nobody knows why does it hum during the night time. Okay, and giraffes, they have a heart that can be around 2.5 feet long. 2.5 feet long, how big? Our human heart is just our fist. If we put our hands together like this, the fist, the size of our fist is the size of our heart. But a giraffe's heart is 2.5 feet long, and a powerful pump is needed to lift that blood vertically up to its long neck against the gravity to reach the brain. Yes, the heart itself weighs around 25 pounds, and you know how much it beats per minute? 150 times per minute the heart of a giraffe beats. Now there's very special thing about this giraffe. The heart pump is so powerful that when the giraffe bends over to drink, the pressure that is created because of gravity would be enough to burst the vessels in its brain, resulting in death. But just look at this giraffe. Does it die each time it bends its neck to drink some water? No. That's the amazing creation of God that we are seeing, because they have something called as the pressure regulating system. It is known as the rete mirabile, or in the Italian language, the meaning for this word is admirable network. God has put in an admirable network in this giraffe's body, which are made up of valves in the arteries and capillaries in the neck, which restricts the amount of blood that rushes towards the brain and when the giraffe lowers its head. So how does it get the oxygen that's needed when it's drinking the water? It needs the oxygen. The brain has to work, right? It cannot be just at a standstill. So there is a special sponge-like thing near the brain that helps, or that supplies a small supply of blood in the brain, because it's a sponge that absorbs just little and gives little bit of oxygen that is needed at that particular time when it is bending over to drink. Yes, so we see that the giraffe is a beautiful and wonderful creation of God. It is yet another example of creation by a designer, for it has exactly what it needs for its size and its environment. We read in Psalms 139 verses 14, it says that I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. Yes, let us praise the Lord for this beautiful creature, which is also fearfully and wonderfully made, just like you and me. So God reminds us this day that He is the creator of everything, and the God who could create this wonderful creature, the giraffe, is also in control of your life. He knows what you need. He knows what are your desires, and He blesses us in such a way that every organ in our body functions at the right way, in the right need that we have in our day-to-day lives. So let us take hope from this beautiful animal that God is in control of our bodies and our lives. God bless you.